My buddy Ben and I were heading to a remote resort island in Myanmar in search of pristine coral reefs.
I'm ready.
In 3 afternoons, we were able to document an abundance of sea creatures, exotic wildlife, and the latest trending German swimwear fashions. Our guide Sam offered to give us a personal tour of all the best reefs and beaches around Nyaung Oo Phee Island. The only catch was that we had to share the boat with 4 other people. Among the plethora of vibrant fish species and alien ocean creatures, we saw many of the world's top most venomous and poisonous animals in the sea, including the top 3 most venomous fish in the world. Many people confuse venom and poison, or assume they mean the same thing. They are both toxic substances. The main distinction is the method of delivery. Poison gets into the body if you touch it, swallow it, or inhale it. A venomous animal has means of actively injecting their toxin into you with fangs or stingers. This sea snake is venomous. And this scorpion is venomous. And the barbs on stingrays' tails are venomous. If you touch the secretion on a tiger salamander and then rub your eye, you'll be in a world of temporary pain. I learned this the hard way. So, many salamanders are poisonous. The fangs on this blue tarantula can inject you with venom. Glands on this toad's skin are poisonous. The stinger on this bee is venomous. And if you gobble down this puffer fish or this porcupine fish, you'll have ingested a potent neurotoxin, and so these fish are poisonous. Now that you know the difference, let's get down to the top 3 most venomous fish in the world. The first location Sam took us to was a rock poking out of the ocean. The sides of this little island were coral-covered walls that descended straight down forever. This was an excellent location to search for sea creatures and compete who could free dive the deepest. Our new friend Sea always won. Here we found the 3rd most venomous fish in the world, the scorpion fish. Scorpion fish have crazy camouflage as they patiently await to ambush smaller prey swimming by. Their fins are equipped with venomous spines, and if you're clumsy enough to get pierced by them, there's a long list of various pains and symptoms you'll get to experience. The 2nd most venomous fish in the world was spotted at the 2nd location Sam took us to. A rocky seafloor covered with corals, urchins, and anemones. As C was scouting the depths like she does, she spotted a lionfish. Lionfish and scorpionfish are closely related, but this one is much more flamboyant. If you get stung, like the scorpionfish, there's a long list of various pains and symptoms, but worse. If you touch a jellyfish, you may get a sudden painful sting. So it's poisonous, right? Wrong. Under a microscope, you'll see that a jellyfish tentacle is covered with nematocysts, tiny spring-loaded harpoons explosive to the touch. Anemones also have nematocysts and, like jellyfish, use them to paralyze prey or defend themselves, but some fish are immune to these booby traps. The 3rd location Sam took us to was a vacant beach paradise. Alone in all this pristine beauty, it's easy to let your guard down, but all wildernesses demand respect. Lurking below your feet here is a master of disguise and the most venomous fish in the world, the stonefish. If you step on a stonefish, it's serious, and there's a good chance you'll get to ride in a helicopter. Symptoms are similar to that of a scorpionfish and a lionfish, but way, way worse.
What did you just see?
Stonefish.
Yeah.
So, well, that's a concern.
I like your statement that you made when you touched him. What was that?
He's really committing to the stonefish role.
Yes, he is.
He's really just doubling down on it.
You gave him a little nudge.
I'm like, I'm pretty sure you're a fish, dude. And he's like, nah. So if you're on the island, just don't walk there.
Right.
That's a general rule.
Every coral reef worldwide has its share of venomous and poisonous creatures that deserve your respect, even if you don't know what to look for, or if you do and you're just distracted by the scenery. The odds of getting tagged by any of these gems defending itself is extremely slim. The only real discomfort you're likely to experience here is a broken heart from one of these girls. We'd like to send an extra special Jesu Timbade to Sam and all the wonderful staff at the Victorian Cliff Resort on Nyaung Oo Phee Island.
These are our guides.
Thank you for this unforgettable dream vacation in Myanmar.
Till next time,
friends.
Happy trails.
Should be friends.
Okay, no,
I'm the only fan here,
no,
bro. I know you say, till next time, friends. Happy trails.
One, two, three.
Till next time, friends.
Happy trails.